as Jesus was returning, there was a great crowd of people around him. A man named Jairus. Jairus was a leader of the church. He comes up and he falls at the feet of Jesus. As a church leader, he had heard Jesus preach. He had heard the power that Jesus spoke with. And in his church, he had seen Jesus heal a man with a crippled hand. The reason that he came to Jesus was because his only daughter, who was 12 years old, she was at the point of death. How many of you have a little girl? Raise your hand if you have a daughter. As we think about this story, I want you to think about being in that situation. It's your little girl that's about ready to die. And all of a sudden you realize Jesus is your only hope. So he leaves the house where his little girl is. He goes where the crowd of people are around Jesus. And people say, there's Jairus, the church leader. And Jairus cuts through the people and he comes to the feet of Jesus. Says, Jesus, you have to come with me. And so Jesus goes with him. They begin to head towards Jairus' house. Verse 42. On the way, there was many people crowding and touching Jesus. They were so aggressive, they almost crushed him. A woman who was there, she had a problem of bleeding for 12 years. Now this story is in the Gospel of Matthew, the Gospel of Mark, and the Gospel of Luke. And the Bible tells us that this woman had spent all of her money. She had tried to go to different doctors and she spent all that she had trying to be made well. Years. She had this issue of bleeding. Friends, in Jesus' day, a woman with an issue like this could probably not be married. No one would touch her. No one would probably come and give her a hug. And she, because of her issue, would not be able to come in and worship together. When people see her, they know, oh, that's the woman with the issue of bleeding. She comes in amongst the crowd. Jairus. to say, Jesus, let's go. We got to get to my daughter. There's too many people around Jesus. He can barely walk through the crowd. You can go to the picture, and all of a sudden this woman comes up and she touches the hem of Jesus' garment. She knows that she knows that she should not probably touch Jesus. But in faith, she believes that Jesus can heal her. Their clothing in that day would have tassels. And there was a belief that there was healing in the tassels. And so she makes her way to Christ and she touches the tassel of his garment. Think of her reaching out in faith and she's believing, if only I touch it. And the Bible says immediately she was healed. And then Jesus, he says, who touched me? All the people are around. And Peter, he says, Jesus, what do you mean? Probably 100 people have touched you in the last 2 minutes. Peter says, what do you mean, who touched you? And Jesus says, someone touched me. I know that power has left me. This poor woman, she thinks, oh no, Christ is going to be mad at me. I'm going to be in trouble. I shouldn't have touched him. But she's been made well. And so she says, Jesus, she explains her issue to him. And she said, I knew in faith if I touched you, I would be made well. And so she's shaking. And then Jesus says to her, this is verse 48. This is my favorite part. Jesus says to her, daughter. This is the only person in the New Testament that Jesus calls daughter. All this is going on. And Jesus lovingly looks at her. And he says, you're a daughter of God. He says, your faith has healed you. Go now in peace. 12 years. No one has really touched her. No one has ever loved her like this. She has nothing. And in one word, daughter. Brothers and sisters, do you know who you are as a child of God? Christ, when he touches us, we don't make him unclean. We don't make him dirty. He makes us clean. He makes us well. And when we reach out in faith, in whatever situation we're in, He restores the relationship with God. He gives us a peace that only He can bring. Think about Jairus. His daughter is dying. This issue with the woman probably made him more upset. Now go back to feeling like Jairus. Jesus, we gotta go. If I'm Jairus, I'm saying, Jesus, can we run? So this woman is healed. And they start to go towards Jairus' house. If you're in your Bible, it's verse 49. Somebody from Jairus' house comes and meets them. And he says, Jairus, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, go help us out.
Don't bother Jesus anymore. Your daughter is dead. As a parent, I think that's hard to imagine. You love your kids so much. Now Jairus' situation has went from difficult, from hard, to now impossible. He's devastated. He's so upset. And Jesus says, Jairus, everybody listen. Don't be afraid. Believe. Are any of you in a hard situation? You go through storms of life. You feel overwhelmed. You don't know what you're going to do. And Jesus says, don't be afraid. Believe. Friends, we said last week, the storms of life, these things that we go through, when we feel desperate, they are opportunities to see the power of Jesus, the glory of Jesus, and their opportunities to trust Him. Their opportunities to trust Him more. So Jesus says, Jairus, don't be afraid. Believe. And she will be healed. When they got to the house, there were people that were already mourning and crying. They were beginning the funeral process. And Jesus, He gets there, and He says to all the people, this is verse 52, stop crying. The girl is not dead, she's sleeping. Some of the people are going, they're like, oh, Jesus. They're like, they're thinking Jesus doesn't know, but she's dead. But Jesus goes right into the house. He tells everyone else to stay out. He takes the mother and the father. Peter, John, and James. He takes those five people into the room. Now in Jesus' day, no one was supposed to really touch a dead body. Or that dead body would make you unclean. Jesus puts his hand on the little girl's hand. And he says, little child, arise. And the little girl, her spirit came back into her. Her eyes opened. She stood up. And Jesus gave her back to her mom and dad. And I think this is funny. He says to her parents, give her something to eat. Verse 56. Her parents were astonished. But he ordered them, don't tell many people. Friends, what do we learn from this story? This story is really a miracle within a miracle. You have the woman with the bleeding issue of 12 years. And then you have the father and his 12-year-old daughter. When you listen to this story, when you think about this story, what do we take from it? And what does it mean to your life? You can go back to the previous slide. The one right before the last picture. Actually, it's the last slide after the picture. This is what I want for us to take away. This is what I believe that Jesus is, this God is doing in our church right now. This is what I pray God is doing in your life. Is that in your heart, your belief in Jesus Christ is growing. That we're coming more and more to the place where we just say, Lord, I trust you. This situation that I'm in, whether it's a sickness that you're dealing with, whether it's broken relationships in your life, whether it's financial hardship, whether it's just feeling overwhelmed with everything, I want us to see that God is bringing us through it. So that we can see Jesus, who has all authority. He has power over creation. And He has power over sickness. He has power over all things. And our greatest fear, He has power over death. We don't have to be afraid. We have to believe. And sometimes in your life, and in my life, God is bringing me to a place where more and more I completely trust Jesus. That's what He's doing in your life. God wants to answer prayer. And God can do miracles in our life. The greatest miracle is that He takes a sinful person and He transforms that life. He changes us into people who love Him, and He gives us eternal life. This is what Christ came to be. More than a miracle worker, He came to be a Savior. He came to save you and to save me. Friends, sometimes in the middle of your life, maybe where you're at right now, you see this woman. You can go back to the picture. She reached out in faith to Christ, the other picture. And I want to encourage anyone today. Maybe you're in that place where you feel unclean. You feel lonely. You feel desperate. And I want you to hear today that we don't make Jesus unclean. He makes us clean. In our situation, we can reach out in faith. We can reach out in faith. And we can believe. Because Jesus has all power. Because Jesus has all authority. He alone is completely worthy of all of our trust. It's always been Jesus. It will always be Jesus. He alone is worthy of all of our trust. I pray for faith. It's really in our faith. In our believing that we're healed. The Bible teaches throughout, all the way through the Bible, we understand that we are saved by grace. Through faith. Friends, I pray that you're encouraged today. Whether it's the woman with the flow of blood, and we see her faith, or whether it's Jairus with his 12-year-old daughter, do you trust Jesus with your children? That's a big challenge for us. We need to pray daily for our children. But we as people, we just have to trust them. I pray that you're encouraged in faith today. Pray that in your heart the Spirit of God builds up your faith. Praise God. Amen. Praise God that Jesus has come. Our Lord. Our God. Our Savior. So I'll pray together.